Olympic Training Center in Oslo, and I'm going to take it through a workout. First, we start with 20 minutes on the bike. For the heavy lifting, I'm going to do a little bit of warm-up.
classical weightlifting warm-ups. All these warm-ups are fairly controlled. They're, I would say, probably just as much a balance and thing as a strength thing.
Exercises that have been mostly the quadriceps, so the front side of your leg. So in order to prevent the knee injuries, especially ACL, it's important to be equally strong in your hamstrings and your quads in the front. So after doing this, it's important to also do one exercise for your hamstrings. And one really good exercise that takes no equipment, just a good friend or a coach, it's something called the Nordic hamstrings. with the main part of the session, the training for the legs. And it usually, a session like that usually takes about close to 2 hours. At the end, do a little core training.
It's just to get the tension in the muscles and be ready for being strong. That's basically what it is.
Pretty good for skiing because the movements can be one way similar, and you always have to keep your balance over what would be the outside ski. This is a typical session that I do 3 to 4 times a week. Start off with about 20 minutes on the bikes, just to get the circulation going. Then a long, good, specific warm-up. I would say a mix between a warm-up, a good balance training, and also training that's good for avoiding injury. And then the heavy lifting session, and then 20 minutes of core in the end. And 10 minutes on the bike just to spin out a little bit so you'll recover faster for your next session.
I will.
I will. I will.